to know his promise. He promised me. He's our deliverer. He will take care of me. We give honor to God and his triunity. To the pastor of this great church, Pastor Bennie Scott, on this your anniversary, sir. Congratulations. And to all these other commentators of Calvary who grace this pulpit, it's a blessing just to be here. And I won't keep you long. We have come to be a blessing to this man of God, to uplift him and to tell him to keep on fighting the good fight of faith. Amen. And Greater Asia, you have a beautiful church. I love the workmanship of your church. When you come here, you feel like you're at church. Many churches don't feel like that anymore, but it's beautiful workmanship in here. The stained glass windows, the crown molding, it's wonderful. If you have your Bible, 1 Peter chapter number 5, and it is customary that we stand for the reading of God's word. Now y'all got to forgive us because we like making noise.
Make noise, dude.
We like praising God.
Yeah.
And we came all the way from the country to be a blessing to you. We won't be before you long. 1 Peter chapter number 5. And we will begin reading at verse number 2. When you have it, say amen. The Bible says, feed the flock of God which is among you, taking the oversight thereof, not by constraint, but willingly, not for filthy lucre, but of a ready mind, neither as being lords over God's heritage, but being examples to the flock. And when the chief shepherd shall appear, ye shall receive a crown of glory that fadeth not away. You may be seated. And for a few minutes, we will talk from the theme, we have work to do. We have work to do. Pastor Scott, we did not come empty-handed. We want to give you this token of love. Because salvation is free, but ministry costs. And it looked like you like to dress. We have work to do. The man of God has been given a very daunting and peculiar task of shepherding God's people. We who serve as the under-shepherd and overseer have a very fragile and valuable position. Because anytime you are taking care of someone else's property, you must handle it with care. And contrary to popular belief, these are not our people. But they are God's people and should be handled accordingly. Now with the chaos that sometimes accompanies this vocation, it is easy to become reclusive and frustrated. But in those moments, you must remember who called you. You have been appointed as the angel of this house.
Yes, sir.
You are a gift to this flock to be used, which implies work, for the edification of the body of Christ. Again, the pastor is a gift. Not a gift likened unto fine china, which remains polished, sometimes hidden, sometimes on display, and used only for special occasions. But rather, the pastor is a gift likened unto an everyday working tool, like a lawnmower, used frequently, pushed by everyone, and does most of the work in an effort to make the house look good. Y'all gonna help me? The pastor is likened unto a toilet. Yes, Lord. Often taking a little bit of mess from everybody just to make sure that nothing or no one gets backed up. We got work to do. We are not here to be celebrities, consumed with the acquiring of fine cars, tailor suits, and well-manicured hair. But we are to be shepherds involved in the care of God's sheep. And if we take care of God's business, God will take care of your business. You ain't got to beat nobody over the head and ask them for nothing. But if you feel right, then God Almighty, God promised, he'll take care of you. Y'all shout, I'm about to go. And it doesn't matter what you may be dealing with personally. You still have a responsibility to forget about yourself and attend to God's feedback. The shepherd does not have the privilege of sleeping on the job. Because if the shepherd is asleep,
come on now.
The Bible declares that the thief comes to steal, kill, and destroy. The demon can sleep on the first bench. But Pastor, you gotta stay awake because there is an adversary coming in like a roaring lion, and you got to be awake. If you don't fight this shepherd, the shepherd does not have the privilege of calling in sick. Because there might be a sick sheep who needs the penicillin of God's word. And if the pastor's sick and the sheep are sick, we got a sick church. We must put our personal issues on the side. Tend to God's people. And yes, we all face our own demons. Don't be so quick to judge your pastor. Yes, Lord. We all have our own demons to fight. I don't want you to think that the man of God is perfect. We all have our demons to fight. And it's a sad thing when we hold the pastor to a standard we're not willing to live. Preacher, y'all quiet. If you cannot hold yourself to the same standard, don't hold a preacher to the same standard. Don't judge the preacher because you call him slipping. Because some of y'all are slipping every Sunday, we just ain't saying nothing. Oh, Lord. No matter what you're going through, you're not to preach anyhow. You got to serve anyhow. They don't know how many times you go to sleep crying, but Sunday morning you got to get up. Shepherd must lay down his life for the sheep.
Work with it.
And always remember the responsibility of shepherding must be done by the shepherd and not the sheep. I found out, Pastor Scott, I ain't been pastor alone.
Tell it.
But I have discovered that they got some sheep who want to do your job. God ain't called them. They ain't been to nobody's school. They don't know the word, but they want to do your job. But I heard the Bible say, be not weary in well doing, you're going to reap good government. If you pay not weary, you may get to a point.
Don't leave me.
Pastor Brian.
Rob.
Big teacher.
Time to go, Rob. We got work to do. Let's wrap around the text briefly. While working for the Orleans Parish Sheriff's Office, the sheriff always reminded us that we were responsible for three things. Care, custody, and control. Similarly, the shepherd is responsible for three things. Care, custody, and control. The text says, feed the flock of God, which is among you. Taking the oversight thereof, not by constraint, but willingly, not for filthy lucre, which is money, but of a ready mind. Feed the flock of God which among you. Meaning take care of what you got, and then God will send the rest. Too often we worry about this church and how many members they got over there. And we worry about what they're doing down in the street. But if you take care of what you got, some may do the pain and some may do the water, but God will do the increase if you're faithful to Him. Some of us, oh, we got some hating preachers. We got some hating preachers. They worry about Paul Martin and T.D. Twist and Frank O'Donnell and how who got this. And if you do what they do, you can get what they got. Baby, watch what you got. Won't be long, so feed the flock of God, which is among you. Take care of what you got. Taking the oversight of hell, not by constraint, not because you're called to do it, but because you love to do it. Because if you don't love to do this job, some Sunday mornings, Pastor Bonds, I like guns, you know? And some Sunday mornings, Pastor Burns, if you don't love this job, taking the oversight thereof, not by constraint, not but willingly, not for filthy lucre. Many of us try to do this job because we think it's glamorous. You sit in a big chair. You know, they see your nice little suits and all that. But they don't know you put up with hell in order to sit in a big chair. They don't know, you know, you wear your tailored suits and all that. You got your nice car. But they don't know the stuff you deal with to get where you got. And you can't do this job for money. Because can I tell y'all a secret? The little bit of money we make, it ain't all that. But the God we serve, He promised to be Jehovah Jireh. He promised to be Jehovah Nisi. And you can't depend on Negroes to pay your salary. Because they flake it, they'll tie this money and won't tie next month. You have to trust in God with all your heart. Fulfilled the lucre, but of a ready mind. Neither as being lords over God's heritage. Again, this is God's people. And some of us think this our folks. This ain't our people, this God's people. And as long as you keep that in your mind, you'll never get out of place.
That's right, Pastor.
I'm so tired of hearing preachers talking about this, my people. And my church. If you think this your people and your church, die. And I guarantee you they're going to get a committee. They're going to vote for somebody else. They're going to put them in. They're going to eat chicken and forget your name. This is God's. And when we treat them as God's people, I found out you'll take care of them better. When we are.
That's right.
We are not Lord, but the Bible says, but being examples to the flock. The work we do should be an example to the flock. When the parishioner sees their pastor, they should be motivated to do better. Real leaders don't create followers, they create more leaders. We so busy trying to get folk to follow us. We so busy trying to get folk to fall in love with us that we have forgot to fall in love with Jesus. And I found out when you fall in love with Jesus, it's something the Holy Ghost dwells in the church. When everybody comes with their mind, stay on Jesus. We ain't come to see what you got on. We ain't come to see what you look like. And we happy here because God's been good to us. He woke me up this morning. He started me on our way. It's time to give, the preacher got to be the best giver. Y'all don't help me. I'm tired of going to churches and they ask for the offering and the preacher don't dig in his pocket. Yes, Lord Jesus. You got to be there when nobody else is there. We got a couple ministries at the church and guess what? Sometimes I'm there by myself. And I just gotta wait until somebody show up. But guess what? If you're faithful over the few, we'll make you ruler over many. Because the responsibility is on the preacher, not upon the sheep. Jesus asked Peter a question, do you love me? He said, feed my sheep, do you love me? Feed my lambs. He didn't ask the sheep nothing, he asked the shepherd. And when the shepherd loves Jesus, he gonna take care of the sheep. Even the ones that like you, even the ones that don't like you, you got to go see about them too. Y'all gonna help me? And the ones that don't like you get sick, you still gotta go to the hospital and say, Father, in the name of Jesus, touch them from the top of your head to the soul of your brain. And I heard James said, he'll make your enemies. The chief shepherd, we're not talking about David.
But the chief shepherd, he's talking about Jesus. See, Jesus came, he died, but he promised that he was coming back. And when he shall come, the Bible says he shall place one foot upon the quaking earth and one foot upon the troubled sea. And when he shall come, he shall have written on his vesture and his thigh, King of kings and Lord of lords. And when he shall come, when he clasps the sky, the dead in Christ shall rise. When he shall come, some folk ain't gonna come to church ever soon. But if you're able to hold on till Jesus comes, when the chief shepherd shall appear, he will give you a crown. And I'm glad that all my rewards don't come from man. God, that's the stuff for you, Pastor. The Bible says your eyes have not seen, your ears have not heard. Keep preaching until you fill this house. And then you have another service and fill that one. And when it get too much, you build something else. But keep preaching. And you got to preach the word. Be instant in season. Be instant out of season. And you don't have to preach money coming. You don't have to preach naked and claiming. You don't have to preach calling and hauling. But I heard the Bible say, one Friday evening, way out on Calvary, he died. He died. Until the moon went down in love. He died. Until the sky turned dark at the hour of midnight. He died. The foxes ran to their holes. The herd ran to their nest.
Turn my midnight into day. My favorite part.